pages. On your PDF, the next part is we're gonna create sections using the new clipping sections command. So for that part, let's open in your the zipped file will have five sectioning models, and we will go to exercise 3, the clipping sections one, and open it. And what I created here is a detail of a foundation where we have the section layer here, where we're gonna put the section. I'll make it the active one. We have the walls, and you can turn those off to see which ones they are. The foundation part, right there. We have the sand part and the earth. So we will follow exactly the steps that are in the PDF. So if you feel comfortable doing this, it's just like we open the file, and then we're gonna run the clipping section command, and we're gonna set the options to these options. So let's do that. So clipping sections command, like I said, it is exactly the same as the clipping plane, except you have seen that we have a lot of other new properties for clipping planes, like the depth, for example, like the name and the label style. So this can be set all at once with the new command. It will not affect you. You can use it to set these options in one go, but alternatively, you can run a clipping plane command and set the options from the property panel. So I'll go sections, create, to run the command. The command name, as you can see there, it's a clipping sections. I'll just give it a bit of space. So the name of the command is a clipping sections command. It will prompt me as to what objects do I want to section through. This is another feature in Rhino 8, which we call the selective clipping, right? Which is you can actually clip through a specific set of objects, not everything if you want to. But if you want to do it the same as the default clipping plane, and you want to clip through anything in your scene, you can just press enter. And now once you press enter, you can see that my clipping plane is changing the widget to red if it doesn't find anything to intersect. But it changes to white when it has something to section through. So I'll just pick the midpoint here to pick the section location. I'm using the default, which is the direction X. You can see that the options are C plane, which is make the clipping plane parallel to the C plane, or we can make it along the X direction, the Y direction, or we want to select some custom direction. I'm keeping it to the default X. Custom depth is ask us, do we want to have a specific depth? If yes, specify that depth. If no, that means it just cuts and the depth is basically infinite at the front of the clipping plane. It asks us also, there is an option to clip, which means, do we want that view to be clipped once we place the clipping plane, or we don't care for it to be clipped? By default, it clips it just like the clipping plane command. Again, those things can be adjusted and changed once you select the clipping plane and go to the clipping plane properties. The name, you need to give it a suffix. So it's basically a suffix, and because this command allows us to place multiple clipping planes. So if we say A, it will generate a name called A00 and the next one we place become A01, so that you'll have unique name to each one of the clipping planes you are placing. The label mode can be dot or can be text or none. Let's just keep it at the default here. There is an option here to save the section view to the named view. What it does is basically gonna save that view of the section to the named view, the saved named views. And it will be basically looking towards that section. And it's a nice way to just set a view to a section really quick. So we'll keep that to yes. And the flip is really you look at the arrow here in the widget and decide which direction are we a clipping, and you can set it to if you flip no, it just basically flips it. Or yes, flips it in the other direction. So I'll just place my section here after I let's just keep that to no, and I'm placing my section. And notice how after I place the first section, it actually shows that A00. And it keeps a gray trace of where my first section has been placed. I can pick another point, but I can also change some of the options there. So I can change that to C-plane. Let's say I want to have a top view of my section. So I want, for example, to place my second section as a plan view from the top. And pick a location here and press enter. And as you can see there, that was very low. So let me just take that up a little. Bring it here. As you can see, I was able to place two different sections or two different clipping planes, and each one of them has some a property set to it. So if I click on the first one and go to the property panel, you will see that the name is A00, the label was dot, there is no custom depth set up, and the section style is by default by layer. We'll go over that shortly. And it actually clips the perspective view. And if you notice that section object clipped, it actually set it to all. That means any object in the scene will be clipped with that particular clipping plane. However, we have the ability to change that to be more, to clip specific objects, and we will do that shortly.